Hey, YouTubers out there. This is Matthew Stewart again with another edition of Let's Drink. And I'm trying a different camera angle because every single time I try to do these reviews, I try to do a little different camera angle every time. So now this is the... I don't know, whatever. It doesn't really matter. It's another set. Anyway, not to get anything slowing down. Tonight we're going to do... It's going to be another Russian beer. If you've seen my reviews before, I did a Baltika probably about a month or two ago. It was Dark Lager, I think. Now this one is going to be the number two. And this is the just regular lager by Baltika, which is a Russian beer. This one's a little lower on the alcohol volume. This one's only 4.7%. So this one maybe might be about the equivalent of like maybe a cider or something like that, alcohol volume wise. But I'm sure as hell know it's not going to be tasting like a cider or anything like that. So without further ado, let's get this thing popped open. Now, can't really tell you I know much history about this specific brand of beer. But from what I've seen in the liquor stores, it goes pretty much 1 through 9. So this is going to be number 2 of 9, I guess you can think. And I've already done number 7, so... And I got two others in my refrigerator. I think that's maybe 3 and 5, I think. So I gotta be on the lookout for the other 5. So I'm kind of looking for that right now. So let's get pouring in the old Foster's glass as usual. I've let this sit for a little bit so it's not too cold, because I have a feeling I'm gonna have to drink it fast in order to make this video short. So when I pour, I really don't like a big head on it. I like to keep it as small as possible. Usually with a lager, you don't get a big head on it anyway, unless you're pouring it straight down. So there's that minimal head, kind of a caramely, kind of golden. I don't know, I guess a caramely looking color, something you would find in a Budweiser or something like that. So again, this is number 2 Baltika Russian beer. Sorry for the autofocus for anybody who's noticing. Definitely has the smell of a German or Russian beer. Very more like a Heineken kind of smells like. Smells like a Heineken. First thing you'll notice is that it's sweet. You get a sweet taste in the very beginning of it, and then it kind of degenerates down into a very, very Budweiser-y taste, very just kind of like ho-hum, nothing special. From what I've noticed, that if this is like a regular lager, a lot of lagers all taste alike. I mean, this can, you can even maybe compare this to a Foster's itself. Very, very plain. Not too trendy or anything like that. It's not gonna have berry flavors or like a hefe, or it's not gonna be like a limey, like a Hoegaarden or something like that, or a lemony. Should I say citrusy? This is very regular. The one thing I will say about these bottles, that in every single one of these Baltikas, is always a big bottle, so you're always gonna get over a pint of beer. This was a pint .9, so it's about 21 ounces. Just about, and you get what you pay for. This bottle is about $2. I mean, $2 for a pint of beer, you're not really gonna beat anywhere. Hope the sound isn't bad on this, because I broke my shotgun mic maybe about 5 minutes ago by dropping my camera, so I'm a little pissed about that. But I'm an idiot, because I was swiveling around this chair of mine, and all of a sudden, whoop, there it went. We're about halfway. Speed it up a little bit, shall we? Alright.
Ugh.
No, not very chuggable. Well, almost done. Last sip. That'd be it. Empty glass, just about. That pisses it off. Well, that was Baltika, regular lager, 4.7 ounce alcohol. You can taste it, it's not very alcoholy at all. May take you a few of these to really even get the party started. I would compare this beer maybe to a Bud Select, something of that nature, maybe a Foster's, maybe. Nothing special about the beer. Just putting it out there because I don't know how many people are drinking Baltikas out there. The only thing I can say is that if you buy a bottle at a store, you're going to get good value for it. You can't really get a $2 pint of beer anywhere else. So, that's about it. Let me find my remote. Alright, that's about it. Thanks for watching. If you have any requests for a beer or anything like that, I'll be more than happy to find it and try it. And other than that, I'll be seeing you all later. See you later.